Hello everyone! In this video you can watch me create a resin geode tray again, and I'm also going to use the Druzy molds and to create a nice effect. And I'm going to show you two different ways of how to use these Druzy molds. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of resin in this case, but I also have tutorials of acrylics, mixed media, and a lot more tutorials, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all, because if you select all, then you don't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. So what I already mentioned, I'm going to create a geode tray again, and I'm going to use a Druzy inlay mold. You can already see the first one, it's a large size. And to create this nice geode tray, I'm using the silicone mold from Molds and Shapes. And this is their middle size tray mold. And they also have a larger one and a smaller one, but I'm using a middle size. And I placed my large Druzy inlay mold into the silicon tray mold, you can see it, and now I'm pouring the colors into my silicon mold, and I'm using the Pinata magenta color. It's an alcohol ink, and I'm using different shapes, and I also mixed in some of my white crystal mica pigment. It's a very shimmery white pigment to give it some sparkle. So I'm going to show you two different ways of how to use the Druzy inlay mold. So the first one I lay into the tray mold, and later in the video I will show you a second way of how to use the Druzy molds. Now I'm using my heat gun to remove some air bubbles. And the color you see now is the magenta color of the Pinata alcohol ink. And it looks not that bright, but if it dries, it dries much brighter. You will see it in later in this video. So on the edge, a darker shade of the magenta color. And I'm going to not pour all the way up to the top, because I also want to add a food safe layer into the mold. There you can see it again, the darker shade. And if you are interested in one of the molds of Molds and Shapes, the link to their new website is in the description box below this video. And I also have a promo code for their new website. If you use my code JustPaint5, then you get 5% discount on your total value order. So that's so great of Molds and Shapes to provide a promo code for you all. So hopefully you will use it, then you can then you get 5% discount. And their molds are of a great quality. And if you buy one of their molds, you won't be disappointed. So I will show you different techniques to create this geode tray. I'm also going to add some decorations on top of the resin. I also going to show you that in this video. But first, the resin pour. So this is the Blackbird. It's one of my own natural mica pigments. Going to add some lines. And hopefully I can create some nice effects on the top side, this side you see now, but also the other side. Because my goal is to use this tray on both sides. I already know that I will have a dip where the druzy mold is, but you can place some nice Lumiere candles in it. Because I get a lot of questions if you can pour into the dip, but if you pour into the dip, then the effect of the druzy will be gone. So the next line next to it is the cotton candy, also one of my own natural mica pigments. It's a light shade of pink, very nice. So what I mentioned you, if you pour into the dip of the druzy effect, then the effect will be gone because you fill in all the structure with clear and then you don't see it anymore. And the next color is the white lily, a nice pearly white color. Also one of my own pigments. And this is a white paste I'm testing because I also want to add pastes to my pigment line. I already tested this color several times. Now some heat on top of the lines. Now a nice gold color is also one of my pigments. It's a buoyant, a rich gold. It's not added to my Etsy shop yet. And this color, will float on top of your resin. I like that very much. I have several colors. I have another shade of gold, but also a copper and a bronze and a silver. The silver is already listed, but the other four colors are not listed yet because, it's a lot of work to make all those pictures or photos for my Etsy shop. And my associate Evelyn Shaver is very busy with taking those photos. Adding a little bit more of the blackbird. But in a few weeks, those colors will also be added to my Etsy shop. A little bit more of the gold. There you can see it. Making lines to create a nice design. It's also all about experimenting. I'm adding heat on top of the lines to make the lines a little bit wider. And I'm using transparent resin, colored with the Pinata Magenta ink. But if you use transparent resin, then the druzy effect will be much more visible. And that large druzy inlay mold I made myself. And in upcoming videos I will show you again how I grow the crystals and how you can make a silicone mold out of it. But that's for later videos. Again, a little bit more of the blackbird. And I'm using the Art Pro resin from Resin Pro, and I think it's an amazing resin. The price is really nice, and you can pour up to 1 centimeter. So the resin has dried, and so what I already mentioned, it dries much brighter than when you pour it. And now I'm going to add some acrylic lines. I'm using a Posca marker to create some nice decorations on top of the geode tray. The Resin Pro resin, you can pour up to 1 centimeter, what I already mentioned. And really doesn't have a lot of air bubbles in it, so that's great. I'm also adding some gilding lines, also from Resin Pro. This is a gold gilding liquid next to the white lines. And I'm adding it with a brush. There you can see it. Yeah, now hopefully I have a nice, beautiful sides, both sides, so that it can be used on both sides. But this side will get a food safe layer on top of it, because what I mentioned, I didn't pour all the way up to the top of the silicone mold. So now there is room to add a food safe layer in the mold. More of the Posca acrylic markers, a thinner line. And I think these markers work great on resin. All the supplies I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with the links to the websites, as I always do. So if you're curious where I buy my materials, check out the description box. Now, a black line, very thin. Again, a gilding line. And if you are interested in my natural mica pigments, I have the link to my Etsy shop in the description box. I also have mica flakes. I like it to use mica flakes, because you can add structure to your resin piece. But you can also use it for acrylics, because you can glue them on with an acrylic binder or another glue. So also, those are in my Etsy shop, and at the moment I'm selling also some Druzy inlay molds. Again, a gilding line. And the black line next to it. And if you are in the USA or Canada, my pigments are also available there in the Etsy shop of my associate Evelyn Schaefer. So the link to her Etsy shop is also in the description box. And she has free shipping above $35, so that's great. And the white line next to the black line. Another white line, but then a thinner one. And this way you can decorate your resin art very nice. And the last line, a gilding line next to the white lines. And then I need to let this dry before I can add the food safe layer. So the acrylic lines and the gilding lines are dry, and now I can add the food safe layer. I also added some silver rhinestones, and I added a golden glitter line, and I used the FIFA Decor glitter pens. And if you really want fine glitter lines, then those pens are amazing. They have them in different colors, but I've used the golden color. And I'm also going to show you now a second way of how to use the Druzy inlay molds. But first I need to fill in the whole geode with the food safe layer. Hopefully you don't hear my friend's bulldog, he's loud again, just as he always does when I do the voiceover. And I think this side looks great so far. Hopefully I also have a nice back side of this geode tray. But we will find out later in this video. The heat gun to remove some air bubbles. I don't use a torch, only a heat gun, because if you use a torch then you have a risk that your resin will stick to the silicon mold. This is the second way of how to use the silicon Druzy inlay mold. You lay it on top of your resin, and I'm adding a jar on top of it because otherwise it will float and it needs to stay where it is. And I'm using the star Druzy molds. You can also find those in my Etsy shop. And then you can create that nice effect in your last layer. Another jar I put on top because this jar is a little bit heavier. And I will leave it on until it's dry. And then you have a nice Druzy effect on top of your resin. So we are 24 hours later and the resin is dry, and now I can take the geode tray out of the mold. And normally I don't have any issues with taking it out of the mold because what I already mentioned, I'm not using a torch. And then we can see how nice the Druzy effect is. So first I'm starting with the stars, and they come out very easy, there you can see it. And these silicon Druzy molds are about 5 millimeters thick, so you will have a dip of 5 millimeters, but I like it. It sparkles a lot. Now onto the larger Druzy inlay mold. Also this one is Yeah, about 5 millimeters. I think a little bit thinner. And also that one comes out very easy. And I think, yeah, I like this side also. So the other side is food safe, where the stars are, and this side is not food safe, but this side you can use to place some nice Lumiere candles in the druzy dip. Yeah, it's very nice, very pleased. Nice effects. I will show you a close-up at the end of this video outside in the daylight. Then you can see the colors much better and also the druzy effect much better. But I like also the decorations of the acrylic lines and the gilding lines. Very nice. The glitter line. So far I'm very pleased. So this is the end result. So this is the side of the larger druzy inlay mold. Some nice effects. So I'm thinking about adding pastes, because I've tested that white paste quite a lot now. And there you can see the nice druzy effect of the larger inlay mold. Very nice. So this side is not food safe. And it has a lot of depth, because you can also see the decorations, the lines, the acrylic lines through the resin. Sparkles a lot. Yeah, nice effect. Nice bright color. There you can see the effects in the white. And this is the other side, also very nice. Yeah, there you can see the druzy stars. I like the lines and the glitter line, very nice. So let me know what you think of my Geode druzy tray. If you like both sides, or only one, or another side. But yeah, let me know what you think. I'm very pleased with the end result. Don't forget my promo codes. You can find it in the description box below this video. Also the supplies I've used, all the links are in the description box. Also the link to my Facebook group. I have a new Facebook group. So if you want to join me, the link of my Facebook group is also in the description box. And there's a lot of other information in the description box. So if you're curious, please check it out. And hopefully you like my Geode druzy tray. And hopefully I will see you all in the next video. Bye!